after visiting the food in English, you know, dissertation, I haven't had time to talk in Thai English. Anyway, it's really nice dissertation that I wish I could have such a device. And, but even so, I think I probably have a difficulty to find smart, nice, good-looking technician with high salary to run the device. But anyway, we have listened to the palm oil market and related palm oil industry since yesterday up to now. So let's change the topic to the palm oil hybrid, which is the upstream product for all the oil palm and palm oil industry. And the hybrid will be in here, the method that we use in corn actually. So it is nothing new for that, the composite seed breeding method. But it probably is not quite familiar among the oil palm breeder. Actually, this method has been proposed last 60 years, 60 years ago, just for, just for the small corn breeding company to produce a modified single cross corn. And actually, this method also being used in most of the, let's say, developing country, for corn breeding, because it's simple and very short time. We will go down to the deep in detail later on. So somebody might have not known that where is our company is, the CPI Agrotech. So look at the map here. So CPI Agrotech is here at Thasep district, Chumbon province, in the upper north of Thailand. And geographically, it has been located at the 10 degree north and 99 degree east, which is a little bit off area from the suitable corn growing zone, which stays from the, let's say, 30 degree south up to 30 degree north. So we consider that in Chumbon area, it is a moderately suitable for oil palm growing area. And besides that, we have annual rainfall is about 1,300 millimeter per year. But most importantly, we have a drought prone period about 4 months a year, and sometimes no rain at all within that 4 months. That's when we have difficulty when we import the hybrid palm from abroad, especially from Costa Rica, Malaysia, which they select under the really high rainfall. So what we grow them in the Chumbon area, the yield drop down at the average annual yield just 15 to 20 metric tons per hectare. That is really low. That's one of the reasons that we have to think that how can we get, let's say, a drought tolerant hybrid oil palm. That's the one of the reasons that we set our breeding program there in Chumbon. And I believe that some of you in this room may have no genetic basis for oil palm breeding. So let me touch you about that matter a little bit. Actually, oil palm has three food forms. The first one is dura, which have a thick shell. So we call it dura form. I forget that these three types of food form is controlled by a single gene, the shell gene, the HS gene. If you have a homozygous genotype for HS plus and HS plus, it could give rise to a thick shell like this, what we call dura. And if you have a homozygous genotype of HS minus and HS minus, you have a shellless form, piscifera form. And once you cross the piscifera to the dura form, you get a heterozygous genotype with a thin shell. in an archive. And because it has a thin shell, so you have more room for mesocarp. That means you have more oil in tenant type. So when we talk about a breeding program, the oil palm breeding program, we will hear these three words all the time. Because the final oil palm hybrid must be a tenant type. So we will hear about these three formulas. So let's touch a little bit how to improve the oil palm. So we have to interpret or intercross among these three forms of palm. So when we cross Dura by Tensifera, you get 100% Tenera. And when you cross Tenera with Tensifera, you get Tenera 50% and Tensifera 50%. Dura by Tenera, you get 50% Dura, 50% Tenera. And if you sell, self the tenera or cross between tenera and tenera, you get 25% dura, 50% tenera, and 25% pacifera. That means that when you want to improve the oil palm, you have to intercross among these three forms of palm and improve dura and tenera. Once you have improved tenera, you can have a pacifera by selfing or crossing between the tenera. So in the breeding program, we can talk about this all the time. So let's look at the genetic function in the hybrid. And this is very important, that so we can see that how we develop the breeding concept in oil palm. In the F1 hybrid, you have the additive action. What I mean additive action? It just simply a mosaical skin high form, like HS plus, HS plus, HS minus, HS minus, that's it. And if you get a heterozygous form, let's say HS plus and HS minus, that's the non-additive action. So in hybrid, you have both the additive and non-additive function. So that one, in selection, how you can get a good hybrid here, you can have good additive, you can have good non-additive, working synchronously. So in selection process, to increase the additive action, we sell or make seed and select the individual performance that we select for the additive. And select for the non-additive, we got to separate the heterotic group. We will see later in detail how to separate that and make cross and check the non-additive. So the good hybrid, that we call a hybrid bigger. Not all hybrid is good and not all hybrid has a hybrid bigger. Some hybrid is in poor yield than the mother than the mother farm. So to get a hybrid bigger, the good hybrid, you got to get an additive bigger. That means a high yield, or good, good homozygous genotype, and also good heterozygous genotype within the same hybrid gene. By looking at the equation that the additive bigger and non-additive bigger, so these two things combine to form the heterotic. The breeding concept, the two breeding concept, the fixed heterotic model, and the flexible additive model. And you will see later what it is. So the genetic aspect of the fixed heterotic model, that means that you want to get the heterozygous gene in your hybrid as much as possible. So the hybrid bigger, it relies on the synergetic action of the heterozygous genotype. Doing that, we got to isolate the two heterotic groups. That means the mother palm and the father palm, you got to separate them completely, definitely. Don't mix it up. So when you cross between the isolated heterotic group, you will get maximum heterozygous form, you know, in the hybrid. And with that concept, this is the simplified diagram from CLAT program. You see that? In the A group, all of palm in the A group must be a dual form. And all the palm in the B group must be a tetralar form. But when you have tetralar, you also have pacifera. Because when you cross between tetralar and tetralar, you get pacifera. Or you sell tetralar, you also get pacifera. So that means a group B is include tetralar and pacifera, the same thing. To form the hybrid, you cross tetralar here to put dualar here. And you get the hybrid. D by T. Now, this is the kind of testing the combinability. D by T. To searching out which D the combine well with T. So you have a U try here. Since it is a D by T, so you get the second patient there 50% D and 50% T. Somehow, if you can get some way to tetralar in this, you cannot sell seed to farmer directly. But you can select the tetralar, make a cloning. So you can increase vegetatively. So every plant, theoretically, it will be the same. That one step. But anyway, for the conventional hybrid, you sell the dualar that form good hybrid with T here, and you sell the tetralar which form a good hybrid with DT here, and use the male, the pacifera here, cross the dualar here. It is seed production. So this seed is a hybrid seed that sell to the white plant grower. You see that? And how to improve this? This one you make cross and sell among the dualar in this form and select the best one, go to the second phase of improvement. And on this side, you also cross among tetralar by pacifera, and select a good one and go down here to perform the phase two. And you start the next cycle, repeat here. So you can see that the dualar form and tetralar form is completely separate. When you make cross between these two populations, you get the maximum heterosis or maximum non-additive function in the hybrid. So in this case, the breeder, they are believing or emphasizing the heterocycle. Another example, this is the modified recurrent selection. I think being used in Malaysia, maybe this one. They have the same basis, so separate the two groups. This is dualar group, this is tetralar and pacifera group. So they use the same concept with the African CLAT program. But the only difference is in Malaysia they have E by E case here, but in Sila, they don't have a taste in there. They just use the visual selection there. And they also make cross here and have you try here to select the good family and select individual in good family to form hybrid. So they take, let's say, have a P here, cross a P here in a series of cross to select the pacifera, this have a good combining ability. More or less, it is general combining ability. After that, they use the P that already shaped good here, and form the hybrid with the D here. This is a hybrid seed production for oil palm grower. And select a good family, come to the second phase here, come to the second phase here. I don't want to go in detail that because you can modify a lot of things. But the point to show you here is if you use a fixed model, you got to separate the two populations. And as you can see very clearly that this is good for big organization or international seed company or international breeding program because it takes a lot of time in Malaysia program here, take 20 years to get 100. My age is now 70. If I use this model, I probably die before I see the new hybrid. For CLAT program, it takes about 12 to 15 years or so to get 100. That's why not many people like to be a palm breeder. You must start early. You must start breeding palm at the age of 20. So at least you can get two cycles. If you start at 70, like me, you can get a half cycle. Now, come to the genetic aspect of the flexible model. In this model, we believe in editing. Now, because we believe that most of the genes are in the range of additive to incomplete dominant. If you don't have a CT background, you will wonder what is the incomplete dominant. So when you cross between the recessive and the dominant, the expression of the characteristic will be on the side of dominant, but maybe not complete. In this case, the homozygous dominant must express that characteristic better than the heterozygous. That's what the flexible model they believe that. Yeah. So in this case, we will accumulate the additive action in the hybrid as much as possible. That means we got to select the inbred, of both sides. When you make cross, you get both homozygous gene and let the heterozygous gene come by chance. So these two believe in these two concepts is quite contrast. But anyway, finally, when you make hybrid, you've got to have a good additive that works synchronously with the non-additive to get a good hybrid. Or otherwise, it's just a hybrid. This is the most difficult part that how to find. After 20 years, you couldn't find your file. So in this breeding concept, we select the cell line within which we use a cell or shape to get a good combination of additive. So it's really contrasted there with the separate model, with the fixed model. So the breeding method will emphasize on the accumulation of the additive, okay? So why we have to use the composite line as the title of what we are going to discuss in detail today. To get a good inbred line in animal crop like corn is no problem because the life cycle is only 4 months. So you can continue selfing 5 times, 6 times, it takes only 2 years. And you get pure line, all additive. Pure line means all additive, no non-additive. And you make cross between the pure line by pure line. to get maximum additive and maximum non-additive in there. And you get a nice uniform single glass. But in case of oil palm, each time you make glass, it takes 4 or 5 years before they set fruit, before you know it, it's good or not. If you want to make a pure line in oil palm, it may be take 30 to 40 years to get the pure line. And even though you don't know yet it's good or not. And more than that, since oil palm is a cross-pollinated crop tree, when you sell only 1 or 2 times, you drop. And probably they cannot survive after 3 selfing. So it's impossible to make a pure line single crop, mixing the crop in oil palm. But for composite set, we will see later how we can get a uniform pattern to produce, let's say, a modified single cross in oil palm with a reasonable of time. So let's see the composite seed method. After you selfing, one selfing, you get an early generation inbred. It has a 50% of homozygous in first selfing, 50%. You may use a single line, 2 lines, or 3 lines model. If you can get a real good S1, a single good S1, you may make a composite from only 1 line by duplicating seed, from the same plant, and plant it in 2 rows like this, and make a massive, make at least 1 seed. So you can fix the yield of the S1 line right away in one generation of process. So the yield of the composite seed will be the same as the original S1 line. But when you make seed like this, let's say probably 1 or 2 times, in palm normally you make only 1 time because it takes too long. But if you have time, you make 2. When you make seed like this, the gene frequency of the component of the lines will distribute evenly in the segregated line. So every plant will look very similar, even though it's not a pure line, but they look similar. So when you make cross between a composite and composite, you will get what we say is a modified single cross with rather uniform. Actually, it's more uniform than what we are doing now in the oil palm hybrid. We use S1 by S1. When you want to produce a lot of seed, the same million of seeds or so, you may have to select probably 10, 20 S1 line. The more you select number, more line, the more that the you can get a variation within the hybrid. This is 3-line model. So the oil palm, I believe that this is a good model because it's only 1 generation per cycle. So it takes about 4 years, 5 years or so. Well, this probably, I just show you the method, probably not suitable for the oil palm because it's long life cycle. This will be good for corn or any animal crop that if you make cross and make a diagonal cross on possible combination here, and you go here and plant it one by one separately and sell again and find a good one and forth, back here, back and forth. The more cycle you do, the more uniform line you get. But this is very not properly used in oil palm. with this, because we make a massive, you select three or four or five lines and make cross. In this case, probably uniformity, not so good, let's say. So if you want a more uniform, you select only one good plan from each row and make cross. In annual crop, you can go back and forth. But in oil palm, our program, we adopt this method. But only a half of it, just do full seed. You will go for a cell again. So let's repeat the full seed here. So we shorten the time and we can perform the hybrid or make cross hybrid, you know, in a reasonable of time. This is what our breeding program we have done, or being done right now. The plan A. This is what I call the fast track program. Because we just started our program last 10 years or so. So we want to have a good hybrid as soon as possible. What we done? We just collect conversion hybrid. I don't know exactly how many, probably 30, 40 hybrid. Around the world. And we have tested for 3 years or so. And finally we select only 7 hybrid. This have a really high yield in DuPont area, high oil content, and have some degree of drought tolerance. So we check the combining ability by intercross and make a diagonal cross of this serine hybrid. This is a comparative cross to see that which one should cross which one to make a hybrid. It's not a real hybrid that we sell to the farmer. So at the same time we make cross here, we also sell this serine hybrid. Then after we cross, we also sell each one of them. So we get this one family. I just show you only 2 families. Actually, we have 7 families. Yeah. Okay, this is A family, S1, B family. And suppose that. A cross with B in cooperative time, we get a potential good hybrid. Okay. So after that, for the first hybrid, we use this S1 and this is it. Bicycle from here, and Lula from here, and for the S1 hybrid. This is a short test cut, but it's still the old conventional method. And now we come to this point in our project. Now we come to this point. For next, we also make a full sip of here, of Lula type, and Tenera type here, and make a full sip of Tenera type here, Lula type here. I thought I already showed you in the last slide. So the next step is, instead of using this one here, with what I said that the uniformity is not quite good. But anyway, in our case, we select only 1% of the S1. That means you grow S1 about 703, we select only 6. The real good one is sick. And this use the sick plant then cross with the principal line here to form the hybrid that we are being sold to the farmer right now. And the next step when we make a composite here, we hope that we can get a better uniform pattern line and make a hybrid here. D composite with P composite here. So hopefully, this is That's what we call a modified single class. This comparable on most, I believe that it will be very, very useful. Yeah. And if you have time, you probably make another full shift next cycle. Oh. Anyway, you have C2CL here, you have C2CL here, but if you want more uniform, you just go another cycle here. If you can go for two cycles or even three cycles, it's going to be the first thing you cross of all time if you do that. And I believe that it's better than make a cloning. Because cloning, theoretically, it sounds good. But practically, it's a very high mutation. We have order clone from, okay, from Costa Rica, let's say. You believe that some code is 100% mutated. You just throw them away with very high cost. And by average, there are about 30 to 40% mutation and that we have to throw away. And make a cloning, you need also 8 to 10 years now, before you get a seed, now go to the pot. And before go to the field, probably 12 years, the same thing. So in that sense, if you go on here for 1, 2, or 3 cycles, we will get already uniform hybrid with a much cheaper investment. So this is what we plan to do it when we get a very good hybrid here. This is our plan A. You see, plan A, we make a double load of work. We family A, we also did the DCOM and TCOM here. Yeah. So it double work. But anyway, let's see our result. This is a T by T, the T by T new trial. It is in this step. It's not a habit that we sell to the farmer, but it's just a cooperative trial, so in this step. As you can see that, we select only top six now. Top six hybrid, T by T, from 21 crosses here, top six. And look at here is the conversion import hybrid. Our yield is very high here compared with the import hybrid. And look at the oil yield ton per hectare per year. Almost double. The reason for this is not because they are not a good hybrid, but they select from a very high rainfall area. But when we go in the Chupon area, the yields go down rain. Look at the hybrid that we select, at our site. If you still there. This is a T by T hybrid now at 62 months, that means about 5 years. Pretty short. The reason for that because it's very dry. But look at that. We get good bunch here. This is the S1, not a hybrid. Number 47. You see, this is the 1 meter here after 5 years. But look at very healthy bunch. This is S1. This is another S1, number 33. Also very short, 1 meter here. And very healthy bunch. Another one. This is line number 57. This is also healthy bunch. But actually, this one is the high ESU for S1. But we have already have some also, the picture is not look good. No, because we already have this. And look back here. The number of 47 and 56, this is the top, and top 400. Look at the in-brain. This is 47. This is 56. So this is our prospective hybrid that we are happy with. And right now we already produce some seed for on, let's say on trial basis. If some farmer want to try, let's try. Somebody asked me that, have you tried this? Well, if you want to publish paper, you have to make a year try 10 years. But in commercial, I won't believe the work I could go like that. You go bankrupt before you sell seed. So we have to believe in our eyes, believe in our selection of the parent, because we also measure you, measure everything on the parent. And we also have a, let's say, a cooperative trial. So let's believe that our hybrid should be in that order. But it doesn't mean that we won't make any new trial, you're gonna do it anyway. Somebody, how can you sell if you don't have a new trial yet? So I asked them, when you import the hybrid form bot, do you have new trial? No, you don't have it either. It literally poor you. Yeah. And this is observation plot at Kuan Kanun District, Pathalung. This is only 20 months. Our hybrid already set for 20 months and look very healthy plant. This is as an observation plot at Nong Khae District, Saraburi. The Thai people may not know that in the vicinity of the Rangsit, Thung Rangsit. So this is very acid soil, pH around 4.5 something. But the plant look very healthy. That means oil palm react totally to acid soil very well. And it should be like that because even in Malaysia, in Indonesia, you even can go on the peat soil, which is really highly acid. This is just another close-up picture. This is only 15 months. 15 months, but look okay so far. And let's see what's next after this first set of the hybrid we will go. The first set of hybrid, we use the hybrid near, the seventh clone of hybrid near, that form the first set of our hybrid. And if you can see that, they are very closely related actually. Very closely related actually. But you still can get a very good hybrid, 47 here and 56 here. This is our number one hybrid there. And we also can get a very good hybrid from here, 14 and 56, now called 14 and 57. That means our assumption of the breeding concept on the additive works. You don't need too much diversity. The hybrid score down. For example, when we cross all this with number one here, somehow we won't get any good results. Even though they are fairly rather diverse. So actually, we take a good hybrid here if we cross linear material. So the next step, the next cross, what we are doing here, now we check the diversity here. You can see the name of the hybrid around the world, which is important here from Malaysia, from Felda, Malaysia, Evolution, Tornado, this from Costa Rica. So by location, it indicates that it's very diverse. Very diverse. So next step, you're going to cross this that already proved that it has a drought tolerant. To put drought tolerant and adaptation gene into the new import, hybrid or import germplasm. You know, we all know probably about more than 50 hybrid and test it for 5 years now. About half of them gone. No yield. They cannot tolerate the drought at Chumpon area. So we have to discuss almost half of that. And all of this also lupus is some characteristic, but not you. But some has a very good food size, some has very good high oil content and a lot of good characteristics. But by itself it doesn't work because low yield. So in this case, the next step, you're going to put our high yield here and interpret some good characteristics from this to our new hybrid in the next step. So we can see the result of this by next 8 years or so. By next 8 years or so. So by next 8 years, you're going to have array of the good hybrid with different characteristics. Big fruit, small fruit, big bunch, small bunch, high bunch number, you're going to have array of that. Because we know that farmers have different thinking and different perspective. Some like a rather small bunch, but a lot of number of bunch per year. Some farmers, they like a big bunch, but less number, the average number of bunch per year. But by the way, when you make cross because you have oil palm, it is a mathematic trend. If you multiply bunch rate by bunch number, that is you. So it's very exciting to get it in 8 years from now. So don't too excited in 8 years from now. And as I see that in plan A, we have a double load up there because we do the composite in T and D. Because we want to get a large number of seed right away to produce seed for farming. But now it's kind of relaxed, right? Relaxed. So we're going to reduce our half workload by half. So we're going to make a composite simply from Terera. So make composite seed among Terera, that means you cross Terera by Terera. You will get B, T, and P at the same time. At the same time. And once you get a result for a cooperative time here, yeah, so you can use P here, cross with D here, or reciprocal right away. But anyway, you still get a few number of plan of B here, so probably you can produce only in the first year, you can produce only a few thousand seeds per year something. So in this case, you need an extra generation to increase the so you select good D and make a composite seed here. So now you can have millions of plants if you want to make cross hybrid. So this is a half load. That means half investment. Okay, thank you. If you have some questions.